Hey guys, I wanted to do a quick video talking about the Xbox One X again, because I'm a little bit excited about my purchase. I track it on Best Buy every day, even though it hasn't left the facility. I'm just really excited and giddy, and let me be, please. I just saw all those people getting excited over the Nintendo Switch, and I saw people get excited during the launch of the original Xbox One and PS4 and the PS4 Pro, and I saw people getting excited, and I got all my stuff late, and I'm just like, no, I get to finally get a console when it comes out. And I get to open it and take it out of the box and hook it all up, plug in my external drive. Oh, I'm so excited. Just let me be excited. Please, don't shit on my parade. I've looked into the Xbox One X, all of its problems, all of its pros, all of its cons. I know what I got into. I don't need your comments, alright? No comments on this video. I don't want any comments on this video. If you guys can't tell, I'm still a little bit sick, so if my voice sounds retarded, that's why. But I wanted to talk about something I haven't heard anyone talk about, because the Xbox fanboy channels, like Crap Gamer, I think you guys know who Crap Gamer is. If you don't know who Crap Gamer is, look him up. But a lot of those Xbox fanboy channels are very strange. Like, you get one that is just, like, super fanboy, toxic, like, ignores fact for emotion. It's just weird. It's kind of like trying to justify that they like Xbox, which is unnecessary. You like it or you don't. You have reasons to or you don't. Like, who cares? But it's a lot of, like, adults, people in their, like, late 20s, trying to justify to their audience of children that, hey, I like this console. Who fucking cares? But I was watching this guy named Colt Eastwood, and Colt Eastwood was talking about how PC players can't build what the Xbox One X does for $500, and instead, what he found in making a budget PC, he did actually a pretty decent video, and he got it to around $600-$700, which isn't that much more, and PCs do a lot more, like, inarguably, but he left something out that I thought was kind of interesting and I wanted to mention. When people ask you, why don't you just buy a gaming PC, there's something that they seem to forget, and that is that video games cost money. This is why I don't think you should be buying an Xbox One X if you're a PC gamer with a large Steam or Origin library, or if you've bought into the PlayStation ecosystem of consoles and have a ton of PlayStation games and, you know, you have a PS4 Pro. If you have those kind of setups, I don't think you should be buying the Xbox One X. I think you should buy it if you have a large quantity of Xbox One games that you want to play better, like Battlefield, like Final Fantasy, like Grand Theft Auto. If you want those games to run at their console best, that would be the place to do it, and that's why I think you should buy an Xbox One X. But let me illustrate my point a little bit more clearly here. If I was to spend $500 on a PC that was just as powerful or more so than an Xbox One X, right? All right, that exists. I can just go buy a PC that's $500. It allows me to do 4K 60fps Titanfall, 4K 60fps Doom. It's a really powerful PC, all right? I can go do that. I'm kind of sad saying that because I'm sitting here next to my $1,400 gaming PC that I got like 3 years ago, and it's starting to show a little bit of its age. Poor baby. But either way, let's say I can do that, and then let's just ignore the fact that I don't have a keyboard or mouse that's really made for gaming. I'll just put up with this keyboard and this mouse. For headsets, I can just plug in my Xbox headphones in and then use my Blue Yeti as a mic, you know, not a big deal. But let's grab 10 games that I want to play in those optimal settings, because the PC is the best way to play a game, like, no argument. So I want to play these games over at PC. Alright, let's do that. Alright, so Final Fantasy 15, that's coming to PC. Call of Duty World War II, I'm interested in that. I like Infinite Warfare, shoot me for it, you know, so that's another game. Modern Warfare Remastered is a pretty game, I'd like to see that in its optimal settings, so I'll pick that as well. Battlefield 1, Battlefield 4, Doom, Titanfall 2, Destiny 2, that's coming out on PC really soon. What's one more game that I'd like to play? Let's just do GTA 5. No, I own that on Steam already, so I'm not gonna cheat with that one. Let's throw in Wolfenstein, because Wolfenstein's a very unique looking game. Let's throw in the new one, so the new Colossus. Now, that's 10 games. That's 10 games that I feel like I'd put a lot of time into, and some of them I'm already putting a lot of time into now, or I have been over the last year. And the PC is the best place to play these games, inarguably, no sarcasm. Now, for each one of those games, I'm gonna charge myself $40. And the reason being is that some of these games are $60, some of these games aren't gonna be $30 for a long time, and the ones that are $30 might not always be $30, all right? Because I'm thinking the lowest I'm going to get these games for that I just listed is anywhere from $30 to $60. So I'm just going to go and say $40, which is pretty cheap. If I got all of those games for $40 each, that's not really a terrible deal. Well, you can kind of see where I'm going with this. 10 games at $40 a game, that's $400. If I was going to spend that much money on games, I probably wouldn't have any money left over to buy 4K Blu-rays that my PC that I built totally has, because you can totally build a $500 gaming PC with an Ultra HD Blu-ray player for $500. It goes without saying that I'm not hating here. I'm not actually throwing any shade towards PC or Xbox One X skeptics or haters. I'm not really doing that. This is why I think if you have a pre-existing library that you've grown over a long period of time on your Xbox, then yeah, you should buy an Xbox One X if you can afford it, and if optimal performance and optimal resolution is important to you. Do you want to play a game like Final Fantasy 15 with no slowdown? Do you want to play a game like Battlefield 4 without any frame drops or stutters during high-intensity combat on one of the larger Conquest large maps? Then the Xbox One X is for you. If you have a couple of games you play occasionally, if you already play on PC most of the time, if you play Nintendo games, if you don't give a shit about any of this resolution frame rate talk and you just play games to play games, I feel you, I'm that way about some games. Or maybe you prefer the exclusives of PlayStation, and hell yeah, go there. If your friends are on PlayStation, go there. If your friends are on Xbox, I would say go there almost, like, regardless of anything else, like, go where your friends are. But even if I just got 5 games, which would be $200, still a lot. I'm not buying the Xbox One X to start a whole new generation of gaming, because the Xbox One X is not a next-gen console. I'm buying it for my pre-existing library of games. A lot of these games I got on great deals, like for instance I got Shadow of War for $7, I got Mega Man Legacy Collection for $6, I got Wolfenstein A New Order for $5, not even counting all of the countless games on Xbox I've gotten for free, because of Free with Gold. Every month I pay $5, technically it's $60 a year for Xbox Live Gold, so 12 months, that's $5 a month. $5 a month gets me 4 free games, all the Xbox Live services I want, plus exclusive deals not available to other people. And to be honest, that's my least favorite thing about console gaming, is that I have to pay for the online service, but the fact that they give me 4 free games a month makes that a lot less bitter. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did watch, then thank you. I had a total fucking brain fart. What am I? Oh, see you when I see ya. Goodbye. I'm doing the outro.
Well, I see him. He's trying.
Stop their escape.
Hey, I will get to the evac ship whenever I damn well please, woman. Oh, that's embarrassing.
Just watch your character clamber for it, and it just takes off without you.
I was gonna say, it showed the animation, and it was like, nope.